Think about this, the US presidential elections are coming up, and because of that, there's a lot of uncertainty in the market, and the prices can move wildly in any direction. Many traders often focus solely on the direction, meaning they bet on whether the price will go up or down. The success of their trade depends on whether or not they're right about the direction. Sometimes, even when they're right, they end up losing money because of poor risk management. Let's revisit that scenario again. It was noted that the direction could be anything, but the event would cause a strong move. This is not just based on a feeling, it's backed by past data. You can see on the screen that prior to an election specifically, volatility tends to spike and then eventually cools off. So, with that information, which trade would you go for, trading on the direction or the degree of fluctuation? The answer seems obvious, you trade on the fluctuation since we don't really have a view on direction. That's exactly what volatility trading is. Sometimes, traders might view it as something negative because of all the uncertainty around it. But guess what? It's what professional options traders do, and with the right knowledge and tools, you can do it too. In this course, we focus more on trading options volatility. Here, you don't have to worry about where the market is headed. Instead, you need to get an idea of whether volatility will increase or decrease and then trade on that. In this course, you will first learn how volatility behaves. This will help you develop a view on volatility. You'll also learn how to trade based on the tendencies of volatility. For example, implied volatility tends to be higher than realized volatility. We can identify this difference and then trade on that. In the short term, high volatility is usually followed by high volatility and vice versa for low volatility. Additionally, in the longer term, it tends to mean revert, in other words, it is range bound. So, if you want to get an idea of long-term volatility, you can reflect on what it has been in the past. This course will take you through creating a strategy around the mean reversion property of volatility. As we've already seen, volatility is particularly known to be higher just before an event and cools off right after the uncertainty settles down. So, in this course, you'll learn how to trade around events by deploying some popular strategies such as long straddle and calendar spreads. These are some of the known characteristics of volatility that you can exploit. In addition to this, you will also learn how to forecast IV using machine learning and trade on that. You will also learn about volatility skew. If you've ever wondered why it's shaped the way it is, in this course, you are about to find out. Not just that, you'll learn how to trade based on these skew values too. Once you learn about the tendencies and behaviors of volatility, you will be better equipped to develop a view on it, generate trading signals to exploit its regularities, and finally backtest your trading strategy. So that was about learning how to trade options volatility, but something that's as important is learning how to manage the risk. Traders usually manage risk by using stop loss and take profit. This is one way to manage risk. But as an options trader, you also need to consider the effect of Greeks on your positions. You will learn how to assess the impact of Greeks on the options positions, and we'll take you through the complete implementation of risk management techniques using Greeks. First, we'll implement this for a single strategy and then move one step further and discuss how to do it on a whole portfolio of multiple options. Learn more about options volatility trading strategies by enrolling to the Quantra course. Enroll now.